Okay, so I think my screen is visible to all of you. Okay. So in the introductory session, we started from the introduction of Python, and also we discussed last time the installation of Python. And for this purpose, we had a look over Anaconda and Google Colab. And as we discussed, that these are two nice workstations to perform Python coding. And this Anaconda is used for the offline work, and also if one is interested in the online work, then one can use the Google Colab. Okay. So now, So in the last session, someone asked about the difference between the Spyder and Jupyter Notebook. So today, first I will discuss these two platforms in detail, and then we will do some basic Python coding in the Google Colab. Okay. To understand this Spyder or Jupyter Notebook, then we installed the Anaconda last time. And if we launch the Anaconda, and then we will get a window like this one. Okay, so here you can see that there is a Spyder, Jupyter Notebook, and also here. So first we are going to discuss the Spyder. Okay, so here you will see if we launch the Spyder, then we will see a exact home page of Spyder like this one. And basically, okay, so here you can see that there are main three blocks. I mean, there are main three part of the screen. So left one and the two, there are two portions on the right side. Okay. So this left one is called the editor, and this is where we will write our code. So basically in the editor, we have to write some coding, and then we have to run, execute and all, then we will get some output over here on this console. And also if there are some variable or plot, then we will get on this multipurpose window. That means this one is used for the variable help and plot, and also this window will show you that which file we are using. Okay. So in the meantime, I have to accept. And also the third portion of this Spyder is the console. Okay, so where we run our code, which is written on in the editor, then we have to see the output from our code will be displayed in the console part. And also we can also give a single line command in the console for the instant output. And there are many important uses of it. Okay, so in the console, one can use the single line code. One can execute the single line code. Okay. So this is the feature of the Spyder. And also if one is interested in the Jupyter Notebook, then again we have to go to Anaconda, and in Anaconda we have to launch this
Darshan.
Darshan,
in the window number 3 you can actually write a single statement and execute it, is it?
Yes.
Okay, I see. Okay,
yeah. Means if anyone is interested in the instant results, then just we have to type some command in the console. So there is no need to write in the editor.
Okay.
In my system, this Anaconda is not there. So I'm just using some online. Can see na ln1, so just write 1 + 2 and put the enter, then this output will come. Okay, in the console part we can discuss. Offline.
So it can be used in the calculator.
Yes, that we will discuss. Now
hello.
Hi.
So actually I had to ask that after you install Anaconda, how do we launch these exactly?
Okay, so for this one you have to go to the window option and search the Anaconda. Okay.
In the C drive, and then an option for lots of files. So how do you access this?
I mean, if you search the Anaconda, then you will see a logo like this one. You can see them on the top of the... So this one, you will see the logo like this one. means an account navigator you see in your option, then you just click on this one and then this screen will come out.
So you just have to click whichever you want to do, right?
Yes. So let's see, if one is interested in the spider, then just click on the launch and it will take some seconds or minutes depending on your machine. And then you will see a screen like this one. If you are still not able to locate the Anaconda, then we can set. Okay, you may share your screen and then we can locate where it is. So if one is interested in the Jupyter notebook, then just one have to click on the Anaconda on the Jupyter. Yeah, one have to launch the Jupyter notebook and then you will see a screen over here like this one. Okay. And so here you can see that this Jupyter notebook is a browser-based tool for the Python scripts. So, and to create a new link and to create a Python script or Python notebook, you one have to click on the new option and then you have to select the Python 3. Okay, then you will see a screen like this one. This is your Jupyter notebook, means fresh new one. And then here you can see, okay, there are some features of this one. So let me tell you that which. Okay, so first one is this untitled, that means you can see that the name display at the top of the page, that next to this Jupyter logo, that you can see that this file, and clicking on the notebook brings you a dialog which allow us to rename. Okay, you just click on the untitled and then you will see that one can edit this one, means as per their choice. Okay, means renaming of this Jupyter notebook. And the one thing that should note, that one should not change the this extension file. Okay, this file should be the .ipynb. Okay, so untitled, and this name can be changed, means my first notebook and all .ipynb should be there. Okay, so further you can see that this is our menu bar, and the menu bar presents the
Just a minute. So the extension is IPYNB, is it? Such a long extension.
Yes.
And just like Spider has PY.
Absolutely. So IPYN means Python notebook.
Yeah, it is for Python notebook. PYNB.
Okay.
Okay, so in the menu bar, one can see that there are different options, means file, edit, view, and all. And also there are other bar which is called the toolbar. And using in the toolbar, one can use that to execute the file. One have to choose some option from the toolbar. And next one is the code cell, where we have to write on our main text. Means similar to editor in the Spider, this code cell is used in the Jupyter notebook. Okay. So now let's move on our main Python platform, that is the Google Colab. Okay, so I think all of you know how to launch the Google Colab, as we discussed in the last session. So this is the main window of the Google Colab, and here you can see that there are many options or buttons. So let's discuss them one by one. I mean, what are these point, let me tell you. Okay, so again, this one is also used for the file name. So we have to click on this one, untitled 0, and then, and also as we discussed, that do not change, do not edit the extension, that is pynb, while editing the file name. Otherwise this might make your file unopenable. Means I think you got my point. Yes. So again, this one is also set, and this is the cell. This is where we have to write our code or add text depending on the type of cell. And now to run this cell, we have to click on this one. You can see, I think, yes. Clicking this will run any code that is inserted in the cell beside it. And you can use the shortcut for this run cell is shift and enter. Okay. So in the next option, there is a button is called this, and this will give the table of contents. So here you will be able to create or traverse different sections inside our notebook, and sections will allow you to organize our code and improve readability. So let me tell you how this will work, this table of content. And like, let's say this is our Jupyter notebook, Google Colab, and this table of content, I mean that we can define the section, subsection, and all. Means if we want to go on the direct on this logical operator, then there is no need to check the whole program file. We just have to click on the logical operator and then we will see here. So this table of content will help us. But I think in the Spider and Jupyter notebook, this feature is not available. So this is the best in the Google Colab. And the second option is the second option.
Sorry, Darshan, what did you say? Which feature is missing?
This table of content. I mean, in the Jupyter notebook, let's say if I have some Python notebook, then I can define section, subsection, and sub-subsection in the Google Colab. But I think this feature is not available in the Spider also there is no such facility, but I think in the Jupyter notebook also this is not available, right?
Darshan, so what you are saying is, it can be as if you are writing a paper and in some section you want to do a calculation, you can just put that calculation calculated into Seed. Is that what you are saying?
Right, sis. Yes.
Okay. That is not there in Spider definitely.
So it is also nice that if we are working with the heavy notebook, then we have to track on the particular cell. Means let's say this is my cell and I put the name of multi-line comment, then there is no need to check the whole output and just click on this one and you will direct go to the particular cell. So I think this table of content concept are clear to all, right?
It is an elaborate mathematical notebook.
Yes.
Darshan?
Yes.
Yeah.
Hello?
Hello, Darshan?
Yes.
I'm saying ki we have to create the table of contents first, right? I mean,
during the coding one can create,
I have to create. Yeah.
Means it's just a user choice, na? If you want to, means there is no need to create table of content. Okay, so user choice.
I guess it should be just like the way you are just trying to write the program. It will just automatically pick the headings and just create a table of contents, I guess.
No, we have to create. I think manually we have to create like this one.
You have to create in the program only, right?
Yeah.
Yes.
Table of content will automatically pick the headings and subheadings. And the left section is purely based on what you are doing in the right section, right?
Right. Says you are not audible, at least for
Sorry. So, what I am saying is, like in LaTeX, you just write the section headings and automatically takes the section headings and creates a table of content.
Right, says.
Okay,
let me show you that. Let's say this one is our Jupyter Google Colab notebook, and let's say I run this, okay? It should be open. Now I have to click on this. You can see the text, right? So I just click on the text and I run And similarly, so here you can see that in the table of content, you can see the check table of content. So one can use like this one, okay? So either one have to select the code, means if you want to run the some script, then you have to choose the code. Otherwise, if you want to make some table of content, then you have to choose the text option, right?
Darshan?
Yes, yes.
This is a Markov language, the text.
Yes, absolutely.
It's not, although they have named it text, but it's a mark,
Markdown.
Script on its own. Yeah, Markdown. So yeah. You can do
but also
you can actually put a LaTeX thing here.
Yes, yes. Means before the coding, if one in the code, one is using some formula, then first just type the formula in the subsection, yeah, some text for this one. So then you can use, yeah, yes.
Subsection hash, different hashes will give you different
Yes, yes. Yes, and if you put the tuple hash, you can see
The size, font size changes.
Yes, yes. Similar to the this one, LaTeX.
Yeah, yeah,
exactly. Okay, so I think you got the point of table of contents, right? So in the Google Colab notebook, there is other option. Another feature is the code snips. So means here you will be able to find some pre-written snip of code for the different functionalities, like adding new libraries or referencing oneself to. Okay, the second option, don't take it seriously. That we will discuss later. Okay. I just want to tell you. So this, the third option of Colab notebook is the files. So here you will be able to upload the data set and other files from the both from your system and also the Google Drive. And if, let's say if, say you want to access some data set for your coding from your Google Drive, then one just click here, means in the option number 4 you can see, no? And this and then there will be option that there your Google account will be mounted in this particular Google notebook. Okay. Okay, so now the next option is that all of code you write will run on the Google computer and you will only see the output. This means that even if you have a slow computer or running big chunks of the code, that will not be issue. Means here you can see that run RAM and disk. So even if you are working with a, some, let's say, slow computer, then this slow feature of your computer will not affect your performance of your Google notebook coding. Okay. So I will show you that how. And this feature will be the RAM and disk size, and also this Google Colab will give the around 65 GB some space. Okay. So this RAM and yes.
For the rest of your sessions, you can give this the session handling to someone else, because you have to go back and add people if they join.
Okay, in the yes. Meantime, I can make you some host, some person.
No, it's fine. But just saying for anyone later.
Okay. Or you just allow everyone. Just allow everyone so that every time you.
Google Meet you can do.
Google Meet. Yeah,
but by we can next session se dekh lena. Now you
yes,
have to
yes,
go back
yes.
And admit everyone.
Okay, so let me tell you the feature of this RAM and disk space. Okay, so this RAM and disk part makes Google Colab more powerful among all the Python platform. So now to see the amount of the remaining disk, just one have to see on this one. I mean that a normal Google Colab notebook will give a RAM of around 13 GB. You can see over here, right? And also, even if you are working with the 2GB RAM system, then there is no issue. One can, and your Colab or your notebook will use around 13GB. Means 13GB RAM is sufficient, right? Yes. So also this will be the extra storage to upload your data or to create the output of a heavy file. Okay, but in the some cases, sometimes the amount of available RAM could be exhausted. In this case, Colab display a message asking to limit the memory used by terminating some session. Okay, so during the session, we have to track the RAM session. Okay, RAM storage. So if we are working with the heavy data set, then in this case, our session might be less. So for this one, one can request for the higher RAM runtime from the Google Colab, I mean from the Google, and you just have to click yes, and then you will see that your storage, and then Google Colab will offer you more RAM about 2 times. Okay, so here you can see that 25GB RAM means if we can work in with the 25GB RAM free of cost. Yes. Okay, so now let's work with the lab. So now we are going to work at how one can write the program. Okay. So I think you got the idea about the Google Notebook, no? Yeah, anyone have the question about the Google Colab Notebook? Please tell. Okay. So now we are going to start our first session on the coding. That means first let me check that which version we are using. Okay.
This is your local notebook, right? You are not shared or anything like that?
No, this is a local notebook. I will share later, okay, after this session.
Share now.
Hello, Supreme.
Ah, I said you can share now also. Okay, now you can see what is it. No, it's fine.
Okay, let me... I just share. Okay. Okay, so now I think all are getting the idea about that how one can test, one can find the which version of Python we are using. So currently we are using the Python version of 3.7.12. Okay. So now let's discuss how Python one can use as a calculator. So one can type the one, and for the run you have to put the shift plus enter. Okay, so let's say if one is in one want to make some addition, then one can use the 1 plus 2, and okay, and similarly, so it's very easy. For the multiplication one can have use the star, of course, or all of you know. And for the division, you have to use this one.
I'll just mention one thing. If okay. Somebody for some reason is still using Python version 2,
okay,
although it's obsolete, now it's no longer maintained, then the 3 divided by 5 will not give you, will give you 0.
Okay. Oh, Python 2 is such an integer mode. Floating point.
Yeah. So okay, if you are using that, you say
3.0.
You say from future import __division__. So future is basically Python 3. It imports the division feature from there.
Hey, so, Supreet, there's an easier way. I put 3 points divided by 5.
But no. So no, I'll tell you the why three, that is from futurisms. Huh? Because if you are making a code and you are sending it to anyone, and that person so it's universality. Okay. That is
So that's why it's always advisable to first we have to tell that which Python version we are using for a particular script, right?
So, yeah. So yes. So and if you're writing a script, you write a shebang on top.
Yes. Yes. Nice.
Horrible name, but it is it. What is this?
Okay, similarly for the modulus, one can use like this one, very simple. Modulus. For the exponential, we have to use the double star instead of this one, okay? Don't use this one in the Python. Just we have to use
asterisk. Double star. Asterisk instead of caret.
Okay. So similarly, one can use, okay. So one can use the this comparison operator like this one. Let's say this 4. Is it correct or not in the similar? Right. मैं ये सब को पता है, but मैं वैसे ही बता रहा हूँ, ठीक है? So that one can.
अरे यार ठीक है यार.
Okay, when see one can use the comparison operator like this one. One can compare the two variable by the double equal symbol, and if let's say to check whether these two variable are equal or not, if not equal, then we have to put like this one. This is not equal. Information is false. Like this one. So for the greater than means for simply one can choose like this one. ये अगर अच्छा था, अगर आप भी साथ में करते ना, मतलब साथ साथ में, it would be nice.
Yeah,
so that would
be a good idea.
Means that's why I mentioned that one should join this session using some desktop or laptop, so that one can use parallelly. Yes. So in the next session we can do coding parallelly. Okay. I will type here and you also type in your personal script and then just run. One can use.
Maybe you can give, you know what, I'll tell you something. You can give a problem. So do this and then the people can do it and come back. So then you display the solution.
Good idea.
Right,
yeah.
Yeah. Okay.
Okay. That's the way to do it.
Yeah, thanks. Yes, yes. So similarly, one can use this cell to check greater than or equal to, let's say this, means whether this information is correct or not. Okay. And similarly for the less than, I mean equal to, and also some one can use the logical operator, means if one is checking the two conditions simultaneously. Okay, let's say I have two conditions like this one. And one can use like this one and put the OR there. But true means either one of these two conditions will be true, and it will give true if either this one is true or this one, okay? But in the AND option, will give false, because for the AND operator these two condition will be true, no? Both these two condition. Okay, so for this to not, So now we are going to next section, that is print command, means how one can use the print in the Python. Then first we write the print like this one, and so again enter, then this will, this double quoted comma screen word will be printed here. Okay,
and also Darshan, put an F over there before the quote.
Sorry.
It's a quotation. So, first, F. Dal there.
F.
Dal.
Okay. Like this.
It's just shift enter. Yeah.
Okay. इससे क्या हो सकता है? पता नहीं चला मुझे. Yes.
So this is something new way to do print in Python. It's called F string. Again, there's a horrible name for it, but whatever. It makes things very easy if you want to print variables. Suppose there was a variable a equal to one. So you just write this thing there, and after your quote, you just write a in this curly bracket. It will print the value there.
Okay.
It replaces all the variables by their actual values. एक सिंगल फ्लैग है, बेसिकली इट्स अ फ्लैग.
फ्लैग, ओके. एंड आल्सो वन कैन यूज द सिंगल कोट, मींस देयर इज नो राइट टू डू सिंगल, वन कैन यूज, देयर इज नो नीड टू राइट द डबल कोट, आल्सो इट विल गिव द सेम आउटपुट. ओके,
double quote, I mean,
it doesn't matter.
I see.
Okay. For Python, quotes don't matter.
Sure. Okay.
So means also in the, okay, these this double quoted word na called the strings, okay? And also one can use the string can be joined together like this one. Let's say if let's say I want to print this A there by three times, so one can use like this one.
Oh, good, like that. Okay.
Yes.
I see.
Like this one, one can use like. Like then one can join these two string by some mathematical operator like that. So here you can see like this one, and also let me put some space before hour so that one can see. Okay. And also there is one can put the space between this double this comma and double quote and mathematical symbol. There is no such issue. There is no such rule that there should be space or not. It will by default will not print. Okay. So now let's move to that how one can use the comments. Means for this one comment, one can use like this one. Means this is comment. This comment section will not execute with your coding. Okay. For example, let's say this one is your main code. Let's say. So therefore, so this comment is used to explain that what type of this particular command is used in your code. So means let's say this is, means this again this comment option is also used for a user's wise, one can use or not. Okay. So let's say if we want to meet the multi-line comment, then one can use. So there is another option to make the multi-line comment is just open three comma and close three comma and write over here. Okay. So this okay, this command is also not executed with your main code. Okay.
this is actually a use for this multi-line comment.
Yes.
They use it for documentation. So if you write a function, after the function you write something here, whenever you will use question mark, let's say you've written a function named Darshan. So you use question mark Darshan, it will print this comment.
Yes, yes. Means one can use these triple quoted command option within the function, right?
Yeah, within the function, exactly. Define function ke baad mein. So that makes it a documentation automatically.
Yeah, and we will discuss the function, okay? So if one is not aware about the function, that we will discuss in this session, okay? So now we are going to create some variable, means variable, I mean that let's, I am assigning the value of x is equal to 4, and then I just want to print x. Similarly, let's say y is equal to, and this one x is an integer, right? For you.
Yeah, but Python doesn't have any types.
And types?
Generally.
But one have to define a split, it means whether it is integer, float, yeah, string.
No, that is what I'm saying. Just like in C, for instance, we define int x or float y or something like that.
Right.
In Python, you don't need to do it. It automatically, according to, so this is, actually that is a float. So if you look at type of x, I think it should be a float.
It should be integer. Okay, let me.
Python, type x.
Yes.
It should be.
Integer. If I put the 4.0, then it will give the float, right? Let's see.
Okay. Good. Yeah. So it takes it according to the input. Yeah, that is what I.
Yes. Yeah. There is no predefined that this is integer or float, but just we have to make. Yeah, we have to type.
But nothing will go wrong if you put int in front of x. That I can tell you.
Yes. There is no need to define. Yes. Right. So let's say this one is, I define the y as a string, then one can just print x, y, z, and just let's check the type of y, and one can use the type is equal to y. So here you can see that it is given that y as a string, right? And so similarly, it's whether it is like this one is 4, y is equal to 4.0, let's see. If one is interested to define a particular, then one have to write like this one, okay?
This basically also converts whatever is inside into int.
Right. If you... means x will give the 4, and it should be give the, y should be 4.0.
I mean, if you give x is equal to int 4.5, it will convert it into int.
Oh, okay. Let me check. 4.5,
okay. Yeah. Now print x.
Okay. Yes.
Okay.
Nice. And also one can use...
Interestingly, can you try 4.6? Does it give you ceiling or floor? Or I think it will just give you 4. It will only give you the near 4, that's it. Yeah,
remove
that without any ceiling or floor.
Right.
Similarly, you can define str.
Yes.
Write 4. Yeah, fine. Yeah, that is fine. Z would be a string.
So this thread will be like comma
string.
Yeah. The string will always come in the quoted, right?
Yes.
Okay. So get the variable type, I mean, we already see that for the to get the variable type, one have to type and just put the variable, that which variable you want to solve. It's type x, it will the integer, and similarly if, that we already discussed, no? That will be the string. And also this Python is the case sensitive. Let's say if I put the x is equal to 4 and this capital X is equal to 5, then generally it will not replace. Okay. So this capital X will not overwrite the x, small x. So let me tell you how this one. This x will give the small case, will give the 4, and this uppercase. So I think you got the point about, no? This case sensitive. Yes. So and also we can define the multiple values like this one. Let's say x is equal to y is equal to z is equal to, let's say, string. All variable will take the same value, okay? And also one can define, one can print the both the string and variable, okay? Like this one, let's say this.
Darshan, try this thing. So x comma y in the above, yeah. X comma, yeah. No, need to, but there was x. Let that be there. So x comma y is equal to 2, 3.
Mm, yes, yes.
So it'll assign x equal to 2, y equal to 3. Mm,
yes. Okay, this feature I'm explaining here. Split, yes. I just say some command for this one. Let's say I make some string array. Let's say apple. Now this x will be replaced by the apple, means x variable will take the output as a apple. Here you can see. And this y will take the ball and see. Now we are going to discuss some list. Okay, so list means to define the list, one is used like this big bracket is used for the list. So now let's say if I print the x will give a empty list. You can see this one. And let's say I define the y is the list will take like this one, separated by the comma. All the entry, yeah, all the item of the list will be the separated by the comma. And here you can see y. And if I print y.
Darshan?
Yes.
Darshan, does it just look at it as a list or does it look at it as a vector?
As a list.
As a list. So there is nothing like a column. There is nothing like
not
a column or row.
No.
Okay. That we will discuss
because it is okay. Because in MATLAB it looks at it as a vector, so that's what I was asking.
Okay.
No, so if you multiply list, so if you multiply a list by 2, it will give you 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. It will not give you 2, 4, 6.
Okay.
Yes, here we can see. So it says if we are confusing that whether it is list, array, vector, matrix, then we just use the type. Means type, and in the y that we can check whether it is list or vector, then it will tell you.
Okay. No, the reason I am saying is in MATLAB, at least in one version, if you put comma, it is a row vector. If I just put blank, it's a column vector. So that's what you're asking.
So here there is something called a tuple, which will be an ordered list.
Okay.
Fine. Okay.
We can even use double square brackets to separate the elements. Then it can be treated as a vector. Or if you use np dot array.
No, it will be a list of a list. It will be a list of a list.
Or if you use np dot array.
Ah, np dot array is separate.
That is different.
Okay. So let's say if I want to check the length of this list, then one can use just use the len and just type the y. It will give the length of this array. Okay. Means three. There are three items in the y list. Here you can see. Okay.
Yeah, you can add lists also.
Okay. Yes.
Oh yeah, you're doing it.
Yeah, I'm doing this. So let's say I'm defining a list like this one, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, okay? I define this Y, and let's say I want to check the position of the, let's say, third element, okay? So I want to check the position of the third item in the list, then I just type the 2, okay? So this, this will start from the 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, okay? So if I am typing this 2, that means it will give the third item. Third item is 3, okay? So one can use comment for this one. So let's say I want to print the last item of this list, and let's say list is very big, so one can use the -1. So this -1 will give the last element of a list. Okay, so like this one, it will give the 7. So means there is if we are using this -1, so that means there is no need to count the total number of item before executing this command. So one can use -1. Okay, so this is nice command to print a last element from any list. So let's say I want to print the first two element of a given list, then one can use like this one. So it will give the first two element. And then there is no need to put the 0, again it will give the same. Okay. So let's say I want to print the first five, then one can use like this.
No, and let's say I can also start from somewhere in between, right? From third to sixth.
Yes. Okay. Yeah. Okay, let me show you 3 to 6.
No,
yes,
third.
Slicing. It's called slicing a list.
Yeah, I see. Okay. Okay, so from third, no, it says from third till sixth or from third six elements? Okay, from third sixth, okay. I see, okay, fine. Okay.
So it starts from 0, 1, 2, 3, okay?
Yeah, I saw that, yeah.
Yes. Okay. Okay, so now the next is like this one. Let's say I want to modify the predefined list. I mean that I want to replace this item number third as like this one. Okay, so I think, but let's say I'm this one. The previously it was 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and I just replaced the third element by the 8, then this list is modified by taking this output. Okay, so here you can see 1, 2, 8, 4, 5, 6, 7. So one can modify, right? And so let's say I want to add some item in the list, then one can use like this one, append white. Okay, so here you can see that in the list, this one item is added, right?
I'd like to add one thing. If it is often in our code, we require this to append stuff. It is very, it's a expensive operation in the sense appending. What appending does is it will take y, it will make a copy of y and then add to it and then again set y equal to that. So there are three operations which go on. So because I'm telling because we many times we require this append function in our codes. Okay, so there is a better way to do it. Try to find, if you want to remove append, don't want to use append, is there a way to do it without using append? There is. That is, suppose beforehand you know that you will have 10,000 elements, okay? But those elements will be generated one by one. So that is, there will be appended to this list one by one, which is starts off as empty. You first create that would actually be,
clear the array means
exactly a zero array and then add
assign
it to it. That is the fast
way. Otherwise, yes, nice point. Yes. So here we just added the item in the list, but it is at the end, right? So let's say I want to add an item in between the list. Then we have to use the insert option. So this will give the insert, and I just
Darshan is very busy today talking about item number.
Shesh already upstream ho gaya, shebang.
Okay.
So here you can see that in the first position, I mean second position, this 77 is added. Okay.
By the way, each of these things are called objects in Python.
Okay.
I mean, every variable you define, you call it an object because it has some attributes.
Doesn't object.
So let's say I want to add the two list into a single list. Just use this one model. So 1, 2, 3, and define the two list, and then one can use the x. Now this x, you can see that. Here you can see that one can merge these two list as like this one, okay? So similarly, one can remove some item using the y dot remove and all that. I will share the script, okay? So I think let's just move to the next one. Is the okay.
Is it drop or remove?
Remove.
ड्रॉप नहीं करता
यार अच्छा मैं अभी ट्राई करता हूं एक बार ले
ट्राई कर हां ट्राई कर
ओके इट्स 1 2 3 4 फर्स्ट लाइन में यूज द वाइल तो सॉरी इज दिस ओके लेट मी यूज दिस
Okay, so three, wait a minute, it took three to be the index or the...
Element. Okay, let
Oh, it is element. So drop, yes. I think is, okay, just to, yeah. So now, okay, so drop you say, or?
Okay.
Drop is for index. Y dot...
I think it will work in the array. Like, yeah. In the list, okay. This feature is not available. I think. Yes.
Okay.
I think when we use pandas, then only I think I use drop. Otherwise, I have also used Dreamo.
Panda mein drop hai. Yeah, it is there.
Because it uses index of that particular list.
Yeah, I thought it should be there also. Delete hoga, DEL hai isme, dot DEL. Delete something. DEL. It's also not there, I think. No, it's not. Okay.
This del is available, what we have to define in a proper way.
Why? Delete by comment. Oh, yes.
So it's just delete the second position, I mean third element. Third. This two is for the third element.
So you have an index use. In fact, you can use a column, I mean, two to three B, you can delete all of them in simultaneously.
Okay, let me check.
Colon. Two colon three. Two.
Comma.
Colon. Two dots. Colon.
Two dot.
Colon होता है ना?
हाँ, yes.
Yeah. So what the heck did it do? It oh no, wait, four. Yeah.
Okay. Nice. Yes. So, okay. Instead of, and this del one can use like this one. Why? Let's say y is equal to 1, 2, 3. So, there is another option to delete particular position is like p o p.
Oh yes, pop.
Let's say I want to delete the third position.
This will just bring out that element. Can you print y again after this?
So you just delete the
position. It deletes, and but it also gives that. So there's a difference. So this is something which I was looking at a long time back. So whenever Python does it, it makes a copy of the thing. And in some cases, you need to be careful which thing you use. Whether the variable has made a copy of it or it is the same thing. Okay. So it's like this. If you do an operation on something, and then let's say you say, iske baad mein f2 define. So yahan pe y is equal to 1, 2, 4, hai na? Iske baad enter mark. Suppose you press enter there. And define x is equal to y.
Yeah.
Haan, x is equal to y. Now print x. Instead of y, you print.
Background में कोई Python को मार रही है
क्या? यार मैं क्या ये हमेशा ये लोग कुछ और करते रहते हैं.
नहीं डंडे से Python को मार रहे हैं.
देख मैं बोलता हूँ.
नहीं कोई बात नहीं यार. But anyway, it's already time. So.
Yes. Write this one.
Yes. So you see, it has, so x was a copy of it, it has also deleted it from x. But if you do pop, and pop may if you do x equal to y, then it can't have a right.
X is equal to y, and just
then now you say print x. Let's see.
Same here.
If there is one option, I think in remove it will not probably work. In one case it does not.
Okay.
It will not change the address.
So I think we can stop here, that we will discuss the next protocol set, and after that we will discuss the matrix, okay? Matrix vector in the next session. What do you think?
Yep.
If anyone has a question, just
we will try it out.
Yeah.
I problem sheet
बना के दे सकूँ। यार इतना भी क्या है यार, अभी बना लेंगे खुद यार। 2+4, 5×3।
नहीं हम challenging problem
बनाएंगे। इन
अकाउंट में दस this is so noisy.
So next time I think you should carry your system that parallelly we can do coding so that it will be smooth, you know?
Okay.
So anyone have the problem that we will discuss in the Saturday from 12 to 12:30, okay? Installation and
problem
all.
In Python, not in general in life.
Or you want to give the life lessons as well?
No. Then I will call CS Nidhi and Okay, then.
Yeah, I will give the problem. Nidhi will find a solution.
Yes.